Hello, my name is Elif. I make anatomy and medicine videos. If you like my videos, please subscribe my YouTube channel and follow me on my Instagram and Facebook pages. In this video, I will talk about structural anatomy of hip bone. The hip bone is also known as os coxae in Latin. Os coxae is an irregularly shaped and flat bone that located bilaterally on pelvis. Before we start, we have to determine orientation of os coxae. I will give you three important landmarks that can help you to determine whether it's a right or left os coxae. First one. There is a girdle, a pit called as acetabulum, which faces laterally. Wing-shaped part of os coxae, which is ala ossis ili in Latin, faces superiorly. Protruding rough thick part, which is ischial tuberosity, faces posteriorly. When we place all these aspects, we can clearly see this os coxae is the right os coxae. We can clearly see acetabulum, and since acetabulum faces laterally, we are looking from lateral view in this diagram. Os coxae is formed by the fusion of three separate bones. These bones are ilium bone, os ilium in Latin, pubis bone, os pubis in Latin, ischium bone, os ischi in Latin. A deep pit called as acetabulum has formed at the junction of three separate bones. Acetabulum means vinegar cup in Latin. It faces outward and forward. Inside acetabulum, there is half moon shaped part that articulates with the femoral head, is called as lunate surface or facies lunata in Latin. Facies means surface, luna means crescent or moon. The part of the acetabulum that's surrounded by lunate surface is called as acetabular fossa or fossa acetabularis in Latin. Fossa means pit, cavity or depression as in a bone. The prominent edge around the acetabulum is the acetabular edge, which can be called as margin of acetabulum or margo acetabuli or limbus acetabuli in Latin. Limbus or margo means edge in Latin. Facies lunata continues with a notch at the inferior aspect. This notch is called as notch of acetabulum or incisura acetabuli in Latin. Incisura means notch in Latin. Antero-inferior to acetabulum, there is a hole called as obturator foramen or foramen obturatorium in Latin. This hole is covered by a membrane called as membrana obturatoria. Obturate means close, so it becomes closed by the membrana obturatoria. This foramen known as foramen obturatorium. The wing part is called as wing of the ilium or ala ossis ili in Latin. This part resembles a fan or wing. Ala means wing, ossis means bone, ili means ili. So we can translate this as wing of ilium bone. Because of this resemblance, it named as ala ossis ili in Latin. The upper edge of ala ossis ili is called as iliac crest or crista iliaca in Latin. Crista means ridge or crest in Latin. The outer edge of crista iliaca is called as external lip of iliac crest or labium externum in Latin. Labia means lip in Latin. The anterior spinosus process of crista iliaca is called as anterior superior iliac spine or spina iliaca anterior superior in Latin. It is abbreviated as SIAS, formed by a combination of initial letters of its name. This is how it's defined in some sources and clinics. Approximately 5 cm posterior to spina iliaca anterior superior, there is a protrusion on the labium externum which is called as tubercle of iliac crest or tuberculum iliacum in Latin. At the level of spina iliaca anterior superior, there is a spinosus process that inferior to SIAS is called as anterior inferior iliac spine or spina iliaca anterior inferior in Latin, and it can abbreviate it as SIAI. Posterior process ending of crista iliaca is called as posterior superior iliac spine or spina iliaca posterior superior in Latin. It is abbreviated as SIPS. At the level of SIPS and inferior to SIPS, there is a protrusion which is called as posterior inferior iliac spine or spina iliaca posterior inferior in Latin, and it can abbreviate it as SIPI. Posterior to the ala ossis ili, the major notch is named as greater sciatic notch. In Latin, it is also called as incisura ischiatica major. Incisura means notch, while major means greater. Inferior to incisura ischiatica major, there is a lesser sciatic notch, which known as lesser sciatic notch or incisura ischiatica minor in Latin. Minor apparently means lesser. Between greater and lesser sciatic notches, there is a protrusion known as ischial spine or spina ischiadica in Latin. Lateral aspect of ala ossis ili is called as facies glutea because there are three gluteal muscles attached to this area. There are curved linear protrusions at the attachment points of each muscles, and these protrusions known as gluteal lines or linea glutea in Latin. These are superior gluteal line or posterior gluteal line. We can translate this in Latin linea glutea superior. And the longest one is called as anterior gluteal line or linea glutea anterior in Latin. And the most inferior gluteal line is called as inferior gluteal line or linea glutea inferior in Latin. Now let's focus on structural anatomy of pubis on lateral aspect. The pubic bone or os pubis has a body and superior and inferior ramus. The upper ramus that passes upwards to the acetabulum called as superior ramus of os pubis. It is also known as ramus superior ossis pubis in Latin. Inferior ramus of os pubis also called as inferior pubic ramus or ramus inferior ossis pubis. The tubercle that located superlateral to the body of pubic bone is called as pubic tubercle. It is known as tuberculum pubicum in Latin. This tubercle forms medial attachment of inguinal ligament. Medial to the pubic tubercle, there is a sharp margin called as obturator crest or crista obturatoria in Latin. Now let's focus on structural anatomy of os ischi. Body part of os ischi made up to 2/5 of the acetabulum, and it is also known as corpus ossis ischi in Latin. There is a thin flattened part which called as ramus of ischium or ramus ossis ischi in Latin. Inferior to the lesser sciatic notch, the body of ischium extends into and it is called as ischial tubercity or tuber ischiadicum in Latin. Spina ischiadica and incisura ischiadica minor belongs to ischium bone. Now let's learn the separate bones on medial view of os coxa, os ilium, os pubis, and os ischi. Internal surface of ilium is smooth and concave surface, which is called as iliac fossa or fossa iliaca in Latin. We are looking at crista iliaca on medial view now. Again, we are looking at spina iliaca anterior superior and spina iliaca anterior inferior on medial view. Also, we are seeing spina iliaca posterior superior and spina iliaca posterior inferior on medial view. Posterior to the iliac fossa, there is a roughened area located inferior to the crest, which is known as iliac tuberosity or tuberositas iliaca in Latin. Inferior to the tuberositas iliaca, there is a ear-shaped surface which known as auricular surface or facies auricularis in Latin. Facies means surface, auricula means ear, so this part is actually articulates with auricular surface of sacrum and forms the sacroiliac joint. Again, we are looking at incisura ischiadica major and incisura ischiadica minor, and between them there is a protrusion known as spina ischiadica on medial view. Between pubic bones, there is a cartilaginous joint, which named as symphysis pubis, and symphysis pubis surface on os coxa known as facies symphysialis. Again, on medial view, we are looking at ramus inferior ossis pubis and ramus superior ossis pubis. Sharp ridge on superior ossis pubis called as pectan ossis pubis. Pectan means comb because this area also shaped like a comb. And also tuberculum pubicum on medial view. There is an arc-shaped line which known as arcuate line or linea arcuata in Latin that marks the border between corpus ossis ili and ala ossis ili and runs inferior, anterior and medial from auricular surface to the corresponding acetabulum. It forms part of the border of pelvic inlet.